What's going on, guys, and welcome back to your Vancouver Canucks franchise mode, fresh off of a second round exit in the postseason to the Arizona Coyotes. Clayton Keller was just too much for us, unfortunately, but it's not all bad for two reasons. The first reason is Tampa Bay Lightning, Stanley Cup champions, and that also means Daniel and Henrik Sedin now have a Stanley Cup ring, which is awesome. That makes me happy, and I'm also happy about the future. I'm not too upset about a second round exit. You gotta know how to lose before you know how to win. And these young guys, they're coming into the NHL, they're extremely skilled, and they need to know how to lose first. And we got a lot of young guys coming up, a lot of skilled young guys. Svechnikov, you know, obviously he wanted to win. He was our leading scorer in the postseason. He had 5 goals and 6 helpers. The guy's hungry to win. We got Oliu Levy, who's coming into his own. We got guys next year like Jack Hughes and what's this guy's name? Cedric Nickel, right? He's pretty much ready to go for next year. We got Oliu Levy really coming into his own. We got Elias Pettersson, who's going to be a beast for us. These guys could both play in the NHL next year, depending on their growth. Now, what we're going to do in this video is we're going to get the re-sign stage done, and it's going to be a big old re-sign stage, plus the draft, obviously. But the re-sign stage is going to be a big one because we have to shell out a lot of money to Sven Baertschi. We got to shell out some money to Jonathan Deline, Chris Tanev, Ben Hutton, we got to give a lot of money to. Will Butcher, Adam Gaudette, Nicholas Jalmerson, Nikolai Goldobin. We got to re-sign a lot of players, so it's not going to be an easy re-sign. And I'm really, really hoping, I have a weird feeling that Sven Baertschi is going to want a ton of money because he had, what, 60 points last year, back-to-back 60-point years. I really don't want to pay him over $6.5 million. I just don't think he's going to be able to repeat that. I just don't know if he's going to be able to be that guy to get a consistent 60-point year out of him. I don't know. It hurts me to not keep him on the team, but if he wants too much, I may have to let him walk to free agency. I know I don't love doing it, but I may have to let the guy walk. So let's go here in the draft. Here is the top five. We are not going to be picking in the top five. I'm probably going to stay where I'm at. These guys all look to be really good. I have to pass moving up in the draft. 81 overall, medium elite. Whew, Vegas, you guys are set. Mark Giordano for a second and Palmu. Okay, that's interesting. Mark Giordano's making a lot of money, and he's 36 years old, 82 overall. Yeah, no thank you. I don't need a guy like that. No thank you. Another guy, 80 overall, Strome, went to the Islanders. Another Strome going to Long Island. They traded away Ryan Strome. Now they get back another one, B. Strome. I don't know who that is. Brad Strome, okay. There he is. Second overall, 80 overall, not bad at all. Let's see your top five. So a couple of power forwards. That's kind of nice to see. Don't see a whole lot of power forwards out there, especially with the medium elites. And then the rest, I think, are going to be like 60 overall now. Yeah, so your top five were elite, but the rest of the guys are just middle-of-the-road prospects. Simone Dupre for Jake Virtanen. Okay. That's an interesting trade. Simone Dupre, $3.8 million. He's 28 years old. He's 76 overall. He probably won't even crack our team. And Jake Virtanen, 78 overall, is a decent fourth liner for us. So, no thank you, Philly. Not happy. So, in the first round, we have the 27th overall selection. And we also have 2 second-round picks. Remember that, because we have a second rounder from, who is it? From Tampa Bay in the Daniel and Henrik Sedin trade. So, let's have a look here at what we got. Wouldn't mind getting a defenseman, so let's go ahead and sort by defenseman. Not interested in taking another forward right now. What do we got? We got the top three guys here. We got Parra, Green, and Schultz. So all three of them are defensive defensemen, 6'3", 205. All right, haven't scouted him. We got Green, who is an exact top six. Alvin Parra, who is 6'3", 198. Haven't scouted him. I think I'm going to go with Green or Parra. He's 6'5", 213. I wouldn't mind getting an offensive defenseman as well, which is more of a second rounder. May have to look at that in our second round selection. But let's go with the Canadian kid listed as a low top six. Or we go with the exact top six. Let's take a risk. All right, let's take a risk here with Para. He's a Canadian kid. Let's take a risk on him. And he is a medium top four. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Who did we miss out on, all right? So there's the green guy. He is one overall worse, plus he's a medium top six, where Para is a medium top four. That was some good drafting right there. I'll take it. And Banting is 55 overall. Schultz is at 55 overall, medium top six as well. I think we made out pretty good there with Para at the medium top four. I'm pretty happy with that. And Heatley was 55 overall. So we have 2 second round picks here. Let's go and let's see what Vegas is going to do. They take Atkinson, who is a 55 overall, medium top nine. McGinnis, bunch of snipers going here. Offensive defenseman, that's the guy that I actually wanted. I should have probably traded up and selected him. But let's go all the way up to our pick. We have 2 second round picks here. Let's go sim to user pick. All right. Let's go. Offensive defenseman, low top four. Wouldn't mind getting that guy, but he is already selected. So let's see what we got here. No offensive defenseman that I see. Not quite sure what I'm looking for here. We just took a defenseman, so I'm going to wait on the defenseman. Is there any? It was a medium elite guy. Ulos, I think I can wait because our second round pick is in a few selections. I'm going to wait on this guy and I'll pick him next selection. Let's go with the Finn here. Let's go. Yussi, 6'1", 187. Or we go with the bigger guy, 6'3", 206. Let's go with this guy, Merrick. All right, there you go. Let's see what he's looking like. He is a low top six. That's not great. We missed out on a medium top six. Hopefully that guy that we scouted, the medium elite guy, is not gone already. McNeely, low top six, so I guess it wasn't a terrible selection. Where is he? All right, let's go with him. Medium elite. I don't know what he's going to be, but let's go ahead, take a risk on him. A Swedish player. Let's see what he turned out to be. If he's like a medium top six, that's cool. Medium top nine, 54 overall, right wing sniper. All right, it's not terrible. I mean, could have been worse. Now we got to just go kind of shot in the dark here. Ottawa wants to move up. They want to take our fifth and our seventh. Or sorry, we want to move up. And I'm not. Nah, I'd rather have two selections than one. No, thank you. Not happening. You want to move up again? Nope, not happening. I'm cool with having two selections. They want to give us a seventh as well on top of this Simone Dupre deal. I'm going to say no. Let's go with a goalie here. Let's go with this guy, Johan Pearson. He's 6'2", 203. Let's go. What's he looking like? A medium backup. Not bad for the fifth round. That's not so bad at all. Could have had a 54 overall, medium top nine. Haven't seen a lot of low elites out there, if any. I didn't want to offer trade, sorry. I want to go ahead and pick our few last selections. I think we have two or three more picks here. I think we have a seventh and that's it. Oh no, we have a sixth as well, so that's nice. Let's go ahead here and let's just go with a shot in the dark. Is there any like exact or any high players? Let's go with Pedersen. Not Pedersen, but Pedersen, who's an offensive defenseman. Another Swede. Our third Swedish player taken is a low top six. It's not terrible for the sixth round. I mean, it is what it is. Let's go with a guy who wasn't scouted to be drafted. Let's go with McDonald. He is a high top six. Nathaniel McDonald. I don't know what this guy's going to be. Could be a late round steal, low top nine. It's not bad. Another Swedish goalie we're looking at. He was a 55 overall. So that's going to be it for the draft. Pretty decent. I feel like we made out all right there. Got a couple of decent defensemen, maybe some late round steals depending on how they're going to turn out. But you know what? I think that was a pretty good draft. We didn't really do anything. We just made some safe picks. I was pretty happy about getting that other defenseman, Para, who is a medium top four, which is really, really nice. So now it's time to spend some money. We got $42 million to work with. Let's see what Sven Baertschi wants. I really don't want to pay him over $7 million. And there it is. He wants 6 years at $7 million. We're taking a risk here. If we do sign him, we have him locked up for a long, long, long time at a big chunk of money, where we already have Ryan Johansson and we have some young guys coming up who are going to want to get paid, like Pedersen and like obviously Jack Hughes. Svechnikov's going to want a lot of money. So I don't want to sign Sven Baertschi for a ton of cash. That's going to put us in a position where we can't sign our young guys. I really don't know if I can give Sven Baertschi that kind of money. I don't know, man. I just don't know if I can do that. Let's look at Chris Tanev here, who wants $5 million for 4 years. That's fair. I'll give you, how about we go with a 2-year deal at $5.4 million? That seems pretty fair. Chris Tanev, welcome back. Ben Hutton, what do you want? He wants $5 million for 4 years. I'd be comfortable at kind of like the same deal as Chris Tanev, 5.4. He had close to 30 points last year, so he had 29 points plus 22 last year. I think he's worth that kind of money. 4 years is a bit much, but let's see what Will Butcher wants. 4 years at 4.75. How about 2 years at $5 million? All right, there you go. Just working a little bit, trying to get better bang for my buck. Adam Gaudette, what do you want? You want 4.9 for 3 years. Wow. Okay, Adam Gaudette, all right. What have you done to make $5 million for me? You've had two 20-point years in the NHL, 25 and 29. That's okay, but it's not worth $5 million. Come on, Gaudette, you gotta work with me a bit here. Same thing with Nikolai Goldobin. He wants 4.5 for 3 years. Oh man, I'd feel more comfortable giving you 4.2 for 1 year, and we're probably going to end up trading Nikolai Goldobin because I can't give him the second line minutes that he really wants. He's not super happy here. We're probably going to trade him for someone more suitable. Now, with that being said, everyone is signed that I want to sign. Nicholas Jalmerson and Adam Gaudette, I'm still thinking of, but Sven Baertschi, I can't give you that kind of money, man. I'm so sorry. I can't do that. Ryan Callahan's going to be released. I'm going to go ahead and sign a few more players for our fourth line and for our AHL team, and I'll see you guys in a second. All right, so let's go here and see what players re-signed and what players are going to want to have to work around their contract here. So Matt Benning's back. Will Butcher's back. Rodin. Jacob Markstrom says no. Okay. Ben Hutton says no. Chris Tanev said yes. All right, all these guys here are for the AHL team. Nikolai Goldobin. Back, which is good. All these guys, yeah, that's good to see. Okay, so that's interesting that Ben Hutton said no. Okay, we'll have to see what we're working with here. But Sven Baertschi, I think I'm gonna let him walk, and I'm gonna test my luck in free agency for another first liner. Adam Gaudette, Ben Hutton, and Nicholas Jalmerson are three guys that we have to work with here. Is it worth it to keep a cheaper defenseman like Nicholas Jalmerson, who is not going to put up as many points as Ben Hutton, or really pay Ben Hutton the big boy money? What about if we gave you like a 1-year deal at like 5.5? All right, I feel more comfortable with that. Let's do that, all right? And then we'll leave Nicholas Jalmerson for right now. And Adam Gaudette, I don't know if I can pay $5 million to a third liner, man. I really don't know if I can do that. How about I give you 4.5 for 1 year? That seems fair to me, all right? You got to prove yourself here. You got to prove yourself. All right, so that's pretty much should be everyone. Adam Gaudette said no, and Ben Hutton said no. Wow, unbelievable. We'll make sure you will sign 5.5 for 3 years. It's a lot, but we need Ben Hutton right now. He's actually a pretty serviceable defenseman for us. And Adam Gaudette, I mean, I don't know what to do, man. You know what? I'll give you your $5 million for 2 years, all right? Come on, that should get it done. Jesus. I think we're going to let Nicholas Jalmerson walk because we have some guys coming up in the farm system that we could give more ice time to, and maybe we could find someone cheaper in free agency. So I think I'm going to let him walk, but I really hope these guys sign. Come on. Are you serious, man? Both these guys said no. I'm giving you more than what you're asking for. You guys are ridiculous. So I just made my two final offers to Ben Hutton and to Adam Gaudette. If they don't sign, okay, Adam Gaudette, you're gone. Sorry, buddy. I offered him 5.3 for 1 year, and he said no. And Ben Hutton said no as well? You've got to be kidding me. These guys, man, I'm giving them more than what they want. It's just the term, I think. The term is what I'm scared of. Oh man, we're gonna have to be big players in free agency here. We gotta re-sign our big guys. We gotta re-sign Svechnikov next year. We gotta re-sign Granlund next year. We gotta give Ole Ulevi big boy money. We gotta give a few players some big contracts here. We have $27 million in cap. Let's give Ben Hutton exactly what he wants. I'll give you more than what you want, all right? 5.2 for 4 years. That has to get it done. Come on. And Adam Gaudette, I mean, I'm giving you what you want as well. I'll give you $5 million. You guys are just toying with me now. I can't do 3 years, man. I'll give you 5. God, that's a lot of money for a third liner, isn't it? Let's go. 5.5 for one, and that's it. Let's see if they sign. There's no guarantee they're going to sign. Gaudette said yes, but Ben Hutton said no. All right, so our third line center is good to go, which is more than I wanted to pay. We have no first liner right now, which sucks, and we need to get at least one more defenseman because Nicklas Hjalmarsson's gone and Ben Hutton is now gone. So we got to be big players in free agency, and oh my God, there's a couple of players out there. Holy, Taylor Hall, okay. You see what I'm saying? We could assign Sven Baertschi for $7.3 million for the next 6 years. Or we can go spend maybe a little bit more than that and get Taylor Hall, who is a bona fide 30 goal scorer. Back to back to back 30 goal years, triple 30 goal years, 73 points last year. Why wouldn't we go ahead and try to sign this guy? We could have Hall, Johansson, and Svechnikov. Oh my God, that's nasty. Let's sign Taylor Hall. What am I talking about? That's a step up from Sven Baertschi, absolutely. There's six teams interested. We're definitely gonna have to make it worth his while. I'll give you $8 million for 2 years. That's more than what you want. It's 2 years less than your term, but I think that can make it work, all right? Now we've got to sign some defensemen, and unfortunately, Nicklas Hjalmarsson and Ben Hutton are the only two good defensemen available. That hurts. That hurts big time. Now, with that being said, I can make a move with Nikolai Goldobin to acquire a defenseman, and then we could sign probably Hanzel for the third line, or we be really patient and we get a player that, oh man, see, I want to see what's happening with Jack Hughes and Elias Pettersson. I don't want to make a move and then those two guys not be ready. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to trade Nikolai Goldobin right now. I'm going to trade him because he's not getting the time he deserves. He's not happy here. He's not going to get the top 6 minutes, which he does deserve. He is a second line player. He's got 98 hand eye. The guy's sick, all right? But we just don't have any room for him. We don't have the minutes for him, and it sucks because he could be so good. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to find a suitable trading partner, and I will be back in a second. We're going to look for a defenseman. All right, let's work out a deal with the New York Rangers to acquire Kevin Shattenkirk. He's making $6.6 million, which is our right. He had 46 points last year. He's the offensive piece that we need because there's been a lot of talk in the comments of saying you need a big offensive defenseman, and I agree with you. So we got Oulu-Levy, Will Butcher, Chris Tanev. All right, those are our three NHL defensemen for next year. That's not good enough. We need some more. So if I could get Kevin Shattenkirk for Nikolai Goldobin, that would be awesome. They want to get rid of Shattenkirk. I'm probably going to have to add something here, but let's have a look, see if this trade will go through anyways. Trade rejected, obviously. So they get Nikolai Goldobin, who is a legitimate up-and-coming, I guess, ready to go. He's ready to be that top six guy for sure. I'm not interested in trading away any of those guys. A second, a fourth, and a sixth, and Nikolai Goldobin for Kevin Shattenkirk. This should go through. Trade accepted. There you go. Kevin Shattenkirk, welcome to your new team. Now, hopefully, Taylor Hall signs with us, and now we need to get another defenseman. So, I mean, we need to do some work here. We need to sign a defenseman. That's what we have to do. Is there any decent guys out there? Henrik Sedin is a free agent. So is Daniel Sedin. Oh, wow. Very interesting. We're not going to re-sign those guys, though. I am going to sign Marty Hanzel, though, for the third line. See, I want to sign Hanzel to replace Nikolai Goldobin. But then again, what if Jack Hughes or Pettersson is ready to go for next year? Then I just kind of have an extra player. But Marty Hanzel could be a pretty serviceable guy, even on our fourth line. So I'll give him... I'll give him 3.75 for 1 year, all right? It's more than you're asking for. It's not quite the term, but it's more than you are asking for. We need some defensemen, man. I might have to re-sign Nicklas Hjalmarsson because that makes us... We have five defensemen now. So pretty much have five defensemen here with Tanev, Shattenkirk, Butcher, Ulevi, and Pouliot. It's pretty weak. We need to get another defenseman. I think I have to go re-sign Nicklas Hjalmarsson. That's fine. Or Ben Hutton. Our top four is pretty much set with Ulevi, Butcher, Tanev, and Shattenkirk. So I don't think we need to sign Ben Hutton. I'm going to go with Nicklas Hjalmarsson here. He wants 4 years at 4.4. How about 2 years at 4.8? All right. How about that? Toronto's interested as well, but I think that's a pretty fair contract. Nicklas Nicholas Backstrom is a free agent. That's a big fish. We'll go ahead and give this Mills guy a contract, and we should be ready to go. All right, so let's go ahead here, have a look. Let's see if Taylor Hall is going to sign with us. That would be massive. I would love Taylor Hall to be a member of this team. That Mill guy signed, which is nice. Marty Hansel signed. Nicholas Jalmerson signed. We're waiting on the big fish, Taylor Hall. There he is, baby. He accepted. I was extremely happy to accept your offer. Your cash offer was most generous. There you go, Taylor Hall. That's what I like to see, buddy. All right, send the next season. I'll see you guys in a second. Everything is good to go. We are all prepared, ready for year number 3. Taylor Hall, new first liner. See you later, Sven Baertschi. $7 million. I can get Taylor Hall for that kind of money. So before the season starts here, let's have a look at our captains and our assistant captains. I think that's pretty fair to keep it on Arjo Horvat with the captaincy and then Chris Tanev with the assistant. I like that. I'm cool with that. No worries at all. Let's have a look at our lines going into year number 3. So it looks like Pettersson made the team, listed as a depth forward. Okay, interesting. Very interesting. Okay, so let me have a look here. Let me change up the lines. I'm going to make them the way I want them to be, and then I'll see you guys in a second. All right, so let's have a look at this team. Taylor Hall, Ryan Johansson, Andrei Sveshnikov, all right? Two pure snipers in between the 92 overall passing center playmaker in Ryan Johansson. Our second line is going to be Marcus Granlund, who is a very good player, alongside of our captain Bo Horvat and the young up-and-coming sniper Brock Besser. So you got a couple of players to pass the puck to, a guy who really knows how to score. We got Jack Hughes, who made the team out of training camp, listed as a depth forward. We're going to give him the shot. All right, we're going to give him a few games in the NHL. If he decides to play well, if he's good enough to play, I'm going to play him. And we got Marty Hansel, who's going to be the third line center. He's got 87 faceoffs, going to be great on the penalty kill. And then we got Adam Gaudette, the $5.5 million man. Oh my God. He's a tough guy to argue with, but $5.5 million, he better show it this year. We got Jacob De La Rose, Elias Pettersson, who also made the team out of camp. He's going to get the fourth line minutes. Again, if he plays well enough to be in the NHL, he's going to stick. And then we got Jake Virtanen. Now, I'm more concerned about Pettersson than I am about Jack Hughes, because Jack Hughes is only 19. He can go play in the AHL for one more year. Pettersson is 21, and I think it's either do or die for this guy. So I'm going to go ahead and bring him up to the third line and put Jack Hughes on the fourth. Now, defensively, Will Butcher, Shattenkirk, Tanev, Ulevi, Jalmerson, Pouliot. I'm totally cool with that. And then in the cage, we got the man, Thatcher Demko, at an 87 overall. And then we got Jacob Markstrom, 82 overall. In the cage, down in the AHL, we got DiPietro leading the way, and our AHL team needs to be fixed. Arbamov is stuck in the AHL, unfortunately. I may look at trading Arbamov. He's kind of my backup plan if Pettersson or Jack Hughes doesn't really pan out, because I can bring up Gaunce and I can bring up Arbamov, and right away those two players can go back to the AHL. So that's probably going to be it for this video. You know what? Actually, I'm going to get a couple games done in the regular season. Let's say 3 games done. All right, let's slow sim 3 games to start off the year with Taylor Hall, with Pettersson, with Jack Hughes, a couple of rookies, and our new faces, Taylor Hall and Kevin Shattenkirk. So we kind of have like a complete team overhaul here. I like it. Overhaul. Haha, no pun intended. But let's go ahead here, start scouting the WHL for 6 weeks. Let's just start it off. Let's go 3 games, see how the kids do. I actually got to edit out the power play and the penalty kill, and then we can get this thing started off. So we start off year number 3 with a back-to-back Vegas and St. Louis, and then we go home to face the Vegas Golden Knights. So let's go here. Game number 1, our new look team, Shattenkirk, Hall, and the two rookies. Let's go ahead here and let's sim 3 games. First period against the Blues, 0-0. Period number 2, still a 0-0 game. Going into the third, and Thatcher Demko gets the shutout. Taylor Hall scoring in his first game, gets the only goal of the night, and it's a big one. There you go. Attaboy Halsey scores in his debut. That's what I like to see. Attaboy Taylor Hall. So let's go here up against the Vegas Golden Knights. Let's see if we can put, let's say, 4 goals on the board, all right? I want to see 4 tonight. I want to see 4 goals, and I want to see one of the rookies get a point. Let's go here. Let's light up the Golden Knights first period. All right, we're down by 1. Brady Tkachuk scores on Jacob Markstrom. So we gave Markstrom the second of the back-to-back. Let's go, second period. All right, we get one. Marty Hanzel, but Brandon Leipzig gets another. Can we come back in the third? No, Shea Theodore and Alex Tuck. Ouch. Okay, 4-1 loss. Another one-goal performance. I'm not going to look too much into it, though. It's only two games in. Could be just a slow start, but I wouldn't mind getting some more pucks on the net, scoring a few more goals here up against the Vegas Golden Knights. First period. Okay, 4-0. That's what I like to see. Svechnikov, Granlin, Johansson, and Brock Besser. That's our top six right there. It's beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Period number two. All right, 4-1. Alex Tuck gets one more on Thatcher Demko, and we're going into the third, and we each get one. Adam Gaudette, the $5.5 million man, and Brady Tkachuk gets another. You know what? Let's go out and get five games done. I feel like simulating five after that big victory. That's three. We'll end it off after the Florida game. I'm just kind of interested in seeing how the guys are going to play five games in. Give the rookies a little bit more time in the NHL. Let's get their feet wet a little bit. Up against Ottawa, first period, 2-0. Granlund and Svechnikov, period number two. All right, 3-1. Will Butcher and Bobby Ryan going into the third. They tie it up. Ryan and Igor Zapp, the third overall pick from a few years ago. The big grinder. All right, going into overtime, going into the shootout. Brock Besser wins it. Craig Anderson can't handle Brock Besser. Scores the only goal of the shootout. I want our rookies to score, man. I really want to see Jack Hughes come up here. I want to see him get a big game against the Florida Panthers. Just for this one game, I'm going to put them both on the first line. Let's try it. All right, let's just see what they can do. Giving them some first line minutes here. Why not? Have a little bit of fun with it. It's early on in the year. Svechnikov going there, and Hughes, you're going there, buddy. Arjo, I don't mean this as a bad thing, playing on the fourth line. We're just going to give Hall and the kids a little bit of a boost here. Let's give the kids a bit of a boost playing with Taylor Hall. Simulate the game against Florida. Let's try here. A little experiment of the day. Period number one. All right, 1-0, Taylor Hall. All right, could be assisted by the kids. Who knows? Period number two. All right, 1-1, Nick Bjugstad, third period. Oh, Nick Bjugstad gets another. We only score one goal, unfortunately. Was it assisted by one of the kids, maybe? Taylor Hall from Svechnikov and Johansson. So, didn't really do anything. It's pretty much like he's playing with his own line mates again. All right, well, we'll change that. We'll go back to the way it was. All right, so we're 3-2 throughout the first five games. Let's see if the rookies had any points at all. I'm going to leave it up to you guys whether the rookies should play in the NHL this year or we should send them down. Ryan Johansson's a point-a-game player. Hall's got four. Besser's got four. Svechnikov's got three. Where are the rookies at? Shattenkirk's got 1 point, minus three. Okay, so Jack Hughes has one helper, and he's a minus one. And Pedersen is a minus one with no points at all. That's all right. I'm not going to be too concerned here. I'm going to let you guys decide whether they play in the NHL or not. Should I give them five more games, kind of see what's up, or should I just send them right down to the AHL right away? So that's going to be it for me, guys. Thank you for watching. Let me know your comments down below. Let me know what you think about the rookies. Am I doing anything wrong? Am I doing anything right? You guys are my assistant GMs. You're a big part of this and need to know what you're going to think. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.